Hi, so this is a small setup that I have created to test the inverter software that I have made. Now, this is the board with power electronics. Now, this is the MCLB board from Microchip. Nothing fancy about this board. It's a board to run three-phase motors, but for our single-phase inverter, I'll be just using four of the MOSFETs. That's two for the high side and two for the low side, and it uses a DSPIC33 series controller. This is my power supply, oscilloscope, current meter, the load. It's a zero power bulb. That's what we call it in India, but it's no way zero power. It's just about 15 to 20 watts. And this is a multimeter connected to measure the output of the inverter. And for inverting the low supply, that is the 12 volts, or the low voltage to a high voltage, I use this transformer. Again, this transformer is not exactly made for inverter purpose. I've just used a general purpose transformer, but connected in opposite direction. That's the low voltage, which is usually the output of the transformer, I have connected as the input. And the input, which is usually connected to the high voltage, that I have used as output here. So transformers are basically there, bidirectional. So we can connect them whichever voltage we want. Only change I have made is this is a it's a center tap 12012. Now I have connected both the windings in parallel so that I can drive higher current. So let's give some voltage and see. So this is the switched on the supply. So as you can see, it's taking 0.22 amps, and this power supply what I'm using has two supplies. So on one of the supply I'm giving about 13.2 volts, second also about 13.2 volts. So it comes about 26 volts totally that I've connected here in series and given it as the supply here. Okay, and as you can see, the output, this is the low side output. So you can see the frequencies, they are varying nicely. So I'm giving a 20 kilohertz, so in sinusoidal fashion. So if one of these, so you can see the supply actually, the PWM duty cycle actually starts from, let's say, very close to 0% and goes all the way to a high side, to a very high value, and then again comes back to zero. And similarly happens for the high side as well, but I don't have a probe connected for the high side. Instead, I have connected the current probe. And so as soon as so the input supply is about 26 volts DC and 0.22 amps, and the output I'm getting about 284 volts AC. That's AC voltage, and the load is currently off. So let me switch on the current probe, switch on the oscilloscope as well, and I'll switch on the load. Load switched on. As you can see, there is pretty much the waveform is kind of sinusoidal, but still there is a lot of noise, which we can filter by connecting a capacitor in the output. So I have connected this capacitor in the output. But still, there is quite a lot of noise, and the load is here. It's a bulb. Let me put my hand so that, and the voltage is 232 volts, so that's very close to 230 volts, which is the rating in India. And the input is now 1.05, so about. So 26 volts and 1 amp, so it comes about 26 watts input. And let's assume this transformer is very efficient, so it should give about 20 watts output. 6 watts is just lost in the transformer, which is quite a possibility, because these transformers are very low cost transformer, cheap transformer that we get locally in India, and they have very poor regulation. And you can see the regulation factor actually here. So in no load it was about 280 volts, whereas when you put a load of so much, about 20 watts, it comes to about 230. So that's a huge regulation number, and which is not very good, but it's quite acceptable because these transformers are very cheap, close to about $2 for the rating what they mentioned. So even though it says 12.0, 12 and 2 amps, I'm just giving 1 amps, but the voltage has already fallen from 280 to 213 you know, in 1 amps input itself. So this is the the output current waveform, so it's on the AC side. And so it's kind of sinusoidal, just ignore the noise as of now. And the load is resistive, so it's a tungsten or you know, some metal filament lamp. There is no inductance in the load. So this is what I have. Let me just show you the on and off pattern. So switch off, good voltage comes to about 284 volts, current to about 0.22 amps, switch on 232, this current, and even the no load current, that's the magnetizing current of the transformer, when the load is actually off, it's quite high. So this transformer actually has a lot of leakage inductance, and the resistance of the transformer is quite high. So those two factors actually relates to the regulation factor of the transformer. So because of those two factors becoming quite high, the regulation factor of this transformer is also very high, and so it's not a very good transformer, but that's for okay for testing, for my testing purpose. So let's check with a kind of inductive load, or a load which is non-linear, and in this case it's a Philips CFL, which is about 11 watts, and that's what the nameplate rating says. And the again, it's currently no load, and I have connected a capacitor here in the DC bus, because that's very important when you have, you know, when you are drawing some current and the length of the wire is high, and it might cause some parasitic inductance in the line. And so when you switch on such kind of linear load, such kind of non-linear loads which draw very heavy current, you know, there are some capacitors in this, in this part of the circuit, in the CFL, which draws very heavy current, and if this inductance in the wire plays a role, then this CFL might not turn on. So to avoid that, I have connected a capacitor which is 1000 microfarad over 63 volts, and that will supply the transient current. So let's switch on and see. Switch on, yeah, it works. Voltage is 247, so it looks like it draws lesser current. Current is kind of non-linear. You see the power is lesser than whatever was taken by the filament lamp. So obviously this lamp is better. And so let's just switch it off and let's check the current waveform. Off, on, good. So just to show you the current waveform properly, what I have done is I have enabled the digital filter, which is a feature available on this Regal scope, and I have set the cutoff frequency about 450 hertz, and as you can see the current is very non-linear, and this is a typical current, the peaky current which you will see in most of the rectifier and capacitor filtered loads, and which is also the case in this case of CFL. And so you can see the current is very much non-linear. So what I have done now is I have shifted the current probe from the secondary of the transformer to the primary, there is the low voltage side, and so the current is significantly higher in the low voltage side, and so the measurement will be much easier. Also the software, so currently I don't have two things in my software. First is the regulation of the voltage, so that's not available in the software, and the second thing which is not available is the current control. So ideally we would like to do a current control, and if we do a current control implementation, it will be on the low voltage side, because that's where the shunt will be placed from the battery, or in this case the power supply. So let's check the current. So at present the inverter is running, but there is no load, So the current drawn is entirely the magnetizing current, and we know that magnetizing current of the transformer, because it's an inductor, will be very low power factor, mostly of 0.4 or 0.5, and that actually can be confirmed from this from the waveform. As you can see, the current is kind of sinusoidal, but the zero crossing of the voltage is somewhere here, whereas the current is somewhere here. So there is a huge lag, so the current is lagging the voltage, which actually confirms the property of the inductor. So let me while this is running, let me just switch on the load, which in this case is a bulb. So switch on, so the current becomes more or less sinusoidal. Let me just reduce the scale. So also I'll remove the channel 1, which is the voltage. So you can see the current is very much sinusoidal. Okay, in this case the digital filter is still on, so that's why the current is appearing as highly sinusoidal. But if we switch off the the digital filter, the current is, it's kind of sinusoidal, but PWM ripple, the inductor, you know, the transformer which is actually charging and discharging at every PWM cycle, so the PWM frequency is still visible. But if we measure the current in the primary while synchronizing the ADC to the PWM, this PWM noise will go off. So what we'll see will be a pure sine wave, very similar to this. This is what we'll see once we actually sample the current with a ADC synchronized to the PWM. So this is good. So again, let's just switch off the current, switch off the load. It falls down, it rises. Nice. Okay, again repeating the experiment by changing this load to a CFL. Again, switch on, switch off, switch on. As you can see, the current is, even though it appears to be sinusoidal, actually it's not sinusoidal. It has higher harmonics, it's more of a spiky. And if we switch off the digital filter, actually we can confirm it. So as you can see, if we switch off the digital filter and just reduce the scale of the current, so you can see the current is very much spiky. So what it confirms is that the current taken by the transformer, which is on the high voltage side, the current drawn by the load, in this case it's a CFL, this is the CFL, and so the same current actually reflects in the primary as well. So that's not something, it's not a new discovery, it is quite obvious. And so if we implement a current control loop in the primary, which is the low voltage side, in the software, actually we can control it. So the shape of the current is faithfully, it is seen on the primary side, the low voltage side as well. So just let me check again with the transient, switch off and switch on, switch off. Yeah, so when we switch on the load, because this CFL, it draws a very heavy current, my power supply has certain limitations, so it does not allow a very heavy current to flow initially, because there is some circuit working inside which will switch on the current control loop. So, and that's when you see the disturbance in the current initially, just the moment when I switch on. Just observe it carefully. Yeah, you see the current is kind of square wave, because that's where the current control loop of my power supply is actually triggered, and it limits the probably a cycle by cycle current control. But once it stabilizes, the CFL stabilizes, the current is more or less the standard current drawn by the CFL. So 283 no load, 241 with the load. So once I implement the voltage control loop as well in the software, so this So the no load to full load will be kind of regulated by a PI loop, and it can be done only to a certain extent. So I cannot actually overcome the limitation or the regulation factor of the transformer. If it is very low, my software will not help much, because my duty cycle will basically hit a certain limit beyond which I cannot go. But so for that I'll have to actually go for a high quality and a good transformer, which has the windings have lower resistance, lower leakage inductance, and the cores are packed tightly, and then a good quality transformer, and that should give me a higher regulation factor, and that's when my software control loop will also work properly. So I think that's all for now. I think the basic software is working good. I can go ahead and make a separate board and start designing the transformer, and hopefully I'll make an inverter for my house. Thanks. Bye.